and welcome our God this morning. Come on, go ahead and just begin to magnify the name of the Lord. Lisaka patutelia manaya. Lozoga baga yagadi sititiliana maaya. Iraka papatu segedegede ya. Lideke katuala namano shindia galabara. There's a steering anointing. We call it the anointing that moves the water. The anointing that rises on the wind. The anointing that uproots whatsoever is stored on the ground. We call it steering anointing. The Lord is coming to steer your life up. Lasuka patu telia daya. Marana no kapatu telia. Izanane ketia katata palodia. Barapatu teka lana namatu teka la. Come on, every one of us.
Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Be your song.
Amen.
In the month of February. Amen. I wish I could hear a living amen. Amen. You will render songs unto God, our creator, a miracle worker, in the month of February 2023, in the name of Jesus. Lord shall anoint your head with oil of gladness. He will anoint your lions with oil of revival. Whatsoever appeared dead in your hand shall come alive in the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Now the month of February has been declared the month of prayer push. I didn't know why they were not able to put the sticker before now. But it shall be the month of prayer push. Every content of the covenant demands that you push it out. Okay? You know God is a spirit. And that's what they call the womb of the spirit. Everything you are going to be is in the womb. The baby first of all exists in the womb. Before he is born physically. And before the child will be born, there will be a push. Whatever you don't push will remain where it is. All your miracles have been released. They are in the womb of the spirit. And from February, we start pushing the miracles. Everything stored for your name shall be pushed out. Everything stored for your house shall be pushed out. Everything stored for your business shall be pushed out. This is your mode of prayer push. So when you are praying the prayer, you'll be praying in faith. Are we here? Why are things working for so many people? And things are not working for me. Everyone, okay? Things are working for. Go closer. There's something they're doing. Are we here? You have to learn how to push whatever your dreams are out of the womb of the spirit. The money you need for the dreams in your heart are in the womb. The car you want to ride are in the womb. The new house you want to live on are in the womb. The husband you want to marry in the womb of the spirit. The Bible says he spoke and they were created. So until he speak, nothing shall be born. In the month of February, we are going to look at the calendar plan of God and we're going to follow it up. And by the grace of God, even before the fifth day of February, the day of grace, many of you shall be celebrating your miracles. So excited, you know. We wake up yesterday morning and then we had the Ashana. When I saw the woman on Sunday or the womb, and they even put on gown doing guy, and she came for the anointing, said, go receive power to bring forth your baby, go and deliver your baby. I didn't know they have two girls. And God did it that the baby came out a boy. Are we here? And then, as I was celebrating that, my friend in the U.S., Willie, they had two girls. I saw a test. My wife just gave birth to a bouncing baby boy. Okay? Same night. I said, wow. God is pushing out the miracles. Come on over here. So many exciting things will be happening. And things will be happening to make you happy. I was telling my wife yesterday, I said, I am praying for the happiness of every member of our church. I want them to be happy. I want the boys to be happy. I want the girls to be happy. I want the elders to be happy. I want the women to be happy. And I know that one of the things that will make you happy is God's visitation. But you must be in compliance. Praise God. You must be ready to push. You must be ready to push. Come and tell your neighbor. You must be ready to push it out. It's not a mood to talk and complain. It's a moment to push. Push. So when you are praying, you'll be praying like someone who is ready to manifest it. Are we here? When we start praying for revival, everything that is stiff in your body, stiff in your hand, stiff in your heart, I say receive revival. I say change. I say change. That is a prayer pattern we are going in. Come on, somebody, are you here? Don't worry. Even today, you will receive miracles. Hosea chapter 6. Hosea chapter 6 and verse 2. After 2 days, will he revive us? After what? In the 3rd day, he will raise us up, and we shall live in his sight. Someone shout, revival. Revival. Come on, can I hear you shout? Revival. The 2 day is the 2nd month. So the time of prayer push in the time of revival. Revival means renewal. Revival means activation. Revival means to make work again. Come on, are we here? So I like you to rise up. The psalmist was praying and was asking God, will you not revive us again? Revive us, Lord God, that the people around us will know that we are your people. You need revival. In the day of revival, every dead thing shall come alive. In the day of revival, every closed door shall become an open door. In the month of revival, every possibility shall become possible. I want you to pray. Spirit of revival, come upon my life. Revive my spirit of prayer. In the name of Jesus, I command the spirit of revival, the spirit of prayer, to come upon my life, to renew and revive my prayer life, my prayer spirit. Lede kataya, aragada katata lodaba, arananu suka pataria nadala, uzalaga pata lanaga, alaka pata lada lagada, araka patu sana, ranananananananara, arapapa puka paranana, irapada braga padaba. Lord, I need a revival. This is my 2nd word in the covenant season. Lord, I need a revival. Revive my life. Revive my prayer life. Revive my marriage. Revive my spirit. Revive my health. Revive my health. Revive my finances. Lord, I call for the power and spirit of revival. Or the power and spirit of revival. Or power of revival. Jesus' name we pray. You know, in those days, we're going to look at it in the evening because we have 2 services today. God took Ezekiel by the winds of the Spirit. And the Bible says he brought him to the valley. And in that valley were dry bones. They call it Valley of Bones, where nothing was working.